We're very excited about it because we know that when we are through that debate, the people of St. Lucia will know who literally wasted in a callous nature nearly $200 million.
That was Prime Minister Philip Pierre speaking ahead of Tuesday's parliamentary debate on the report of the St. Jude Hospital Reconstruction Project Review Committee, a debate which opposition leader Alan Chastanet has deemed historic, as he says this is the first time parliamentarians were debating on a decision already taken by cabinet.
Parliament is normally an institution that deals with legislation and also deals with approving expenditure. But here it is, we have a motion coming to the House asking Parliament to advise cabinet. Now, what's interesting is that a cabinet decision on this issue had already been made. And in fact, when you read the report on page 3 of their report, it starts off with that cabinet had made a decision and given them the directive to proceed using phase 1, the original site.
The review committee was commissioned in 2021 after the Pierre administration took office and tasked with recommending the best way forward with the St. Jude reconstruction project. The Prime Minister had revealed during a House sitting in November 2021 that based on the committee's findings, that his administration would proceed with finishing phase 1, the original structures of the project. This, he said, was more feasible and cost-effective than to proceed with the structures erected under the former Alan Chastanet administration, which the review committee had found to be only 30% complete. During a pre-cabinet brief in November last year, Health Minister Moses Jabatis had disclosed that the government was engaging several parties interested in acquiring the structures when asked about what would become of these structures. Ahead of Tuesday's debate, the Health Minister reiterated the direction the Pierre administration would take with the project.
The most recent review committee did recommend that we go to phase one of the project, which is really the former St. Jude Hospital, and to incorporate one or two buildings that were put on ground recently. So the recommendation is actually to not continue the new box or the new building which the last government started. That is the actual recommendation. And we are going to spend time today to explain these recommendations. And these recommendations are not coming from politicians. These recommendations are coming from professionals.
But there appears to be a lack of understanding or knowledge among cabinet ministers about how the current administration is proceeding with the project. As minutes later, after interviewing the health minister, the prime minister indicated that his administration would be incorporating part of what the former UWP constructed.
Two other buildings are going to be used together with the original central buildings.
Two of what, the previous administration?
Yes. Two of the buildings from the box.
This and other information in the review committee's report says opposition leader Alan Chastanet indicates that the administration has no sure plan for the project.
This government continues to talk out of both sides of its mouth. So in the report, in the bigger building, what they call the box, they question the cladding as to whether it's fireproof and whether it's suitable. Yet, they're prepared to move into a building which has the same cladding.
For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.